Hi, and welcome to another Type With Me. In this week's episode, I want to talk about Esbuild for TypeScript projects. So let's see, first of all, what Esbuild is. So if you go to the website Esbuild, we see that it's an extremely fast JavaScript bundler. It's faster than rollup. Then parcel 2, and then webpack 4 and 5. So I'm very curious how this will work out with TypeScript. I don't like these bundlers, right? Because they are complex and a lot of issues that you always have with them. So I'm very curious how this will play out against these other libraries. Are you with me? Well, let's see how this will work out. So I'm going to install yarn install. Or add, sorry, Esbuild mind, because it's a development package, right? So here we are. Great. So I want to have two folders. One folder is the source, right? Another folder will be the library. So here we are. And then I put here index.ts into the source folder. I say move, right, great. So we are here. And then I need to have a new file. That file needs to be called esbuild.config.js. And it will get the following content. And what is the content? Well, the content is here we have Esbuild, right? We have installed that, so that's correct. We also, because it will be a node application, we need to install Esbuild in node externals. So I'm gonna add that as well. Yarn add on this one minus D. And then we're going to install it. Very excited, right? But okay, we just need that. Then you see that our entry point is source index.ts, which is right here. Our output folder would be lib/index.ts. Then we have bundle true, minify true, platform node, source map true, target node 14, plugins node externals plugin. And when there is an error, we just get process.exit1. And that's it. You just need to have an Esbuild config for that, right? So one of the caveats that it has is that it doesn't do type checking. So for that, you just need to use your Visual Studio Code to really have that kind of error messaging, and you get something red, right? Like we have right here. But okay, I'm just gonna add here tsconfig, config.json, and here we have our compiler options. We said that emit declaration only is true and declaration is true, so that's something that you also need to compile everything. Right, so what we now can do is do node, and then we can do esbuild.config.js, and he executed that one. And then if we see here your library, you'll see that we have index.js and we have index.js.map, right? And here you see that he just going to go to source/index.ts. I'm very curious if this is going to work, so I can do node /lib/index.js, and here we go, our application works. We get hello, my name is starting with G, and we get world 1. So he just executes what we want. And if you saw it before, it's very, very fast, right? It's very, very fast. Isn't that amazing? It's blazing fast to just execute everything that we want here for our TypeScript project. Of course, it's a very small file. It's not a lot of TypeScript that's been written right here. But again, I'm really excited by ESBuild. You don't need a lot of configuration right here. Of course, here our target is node 14 and node externals plugin. I think if you really want to have something for the browser, that's also possible. Just experiment a little bit with the target right here. And then, of course, you don't need to plug in node externals plugin. So I hope you learned something from this. I hope you're gonna use ESBuild or also try to experiment with it like I did in the past and in this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. See you next time. Bye.